Portuguese arrived in Sri Lanka as conquerors in the year 1505. They ruled the island till the year 1602. They introduced their religion, language and culture, which were readily absorbed by the inhabitants. They brought with them Roman Catholic missionaries to spread their religion. These missionaries established schools of learning in the island. The language of administration in the country during their period of occupation was Portuguese, so much so that some of the Portuguese words are still prevalent in the Sinhala and Tamil languages. The invaders encouraged their race to intermarry among the natives. Thereby, the people quickly learned their manners and customs. For the first time, Western forms of dress were seen in the island. The descendants of the Portuguese retain to this day some of the traits left behind by their ancestors. Whenever they celebrated important events like weddings or other memorable happy events within the community, dancing formed part of the revelry. Dances like the quadrille, lanza, and the cafrinha were danced. The lanza and the cafrinha are in vogue and take pride of place on such occasions. They sometimes dance through the night in jubilation. They adhere to custom even when dancing. For example, gents do not dance with their lady partners unless they are in full attire. Bowing to their partners during different phases of the dances is done to show respect to the partner. The dancers dance to music that was passed down the last few centuries. An ensemble of experienced musicians perform for this purpose. Among the musical instruments played, the violin and the drum, locally known as the rabana, are the ones traditionally used. The tambourine and the musical triangle are others used for accompaniment. The first presentation of dancers you are about to see is named the lanza. This is danced in five successive parts in a preset order by four couples. Each part has its corresponding music. The couples, while dancing, adhere to different patterns in dance formation.
Thank you. acaba d'aquí, ja t'hi preguntem. Quin és el camp nostre camp de castigo? Aquest castigo és l'immigrant nostre, nostre dentis, per ser vist, dona, otro, ser vist boiar, quin és el castigo d'ell? Quin és el camp nostre, aquí molt content. Aquí veig que nostre content i no sé qui m'hi ha parat. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Rodrigues, the Heegal, and the Heegal, Father, you, a chapel officer, Sister Irene, and Master, and ladies and gentlemen, today we are happy to welcome our chief guest, De Costa, and associate Mr. Kingwood and Joar, who are present here to see the key, very interested to promote relations between Sri Lanka and Portugal. And in this context, we have with us today Mr. Adelino Rodrigues Costa from the Oriental Foundation in Portugal. The Oriental Foundation is a foundation which is an agency which has been involved in promoting Portuguese culture, Portuguese language, and so on. And Mr. Da Costa is in fact in charge of the Oriental Foundation's office in Goa. And it is in this context that he is coming to see you, to speak to you, and he is very keen to come all this way in Batticaloa to meet you. We are very happy, and we certainly hope that this
language is not important. If I speak good Portuguese, if you prefer Portuguese because you speak a good English, if I speak bad English. It is an honor to stay here with so many friends. You to everybody. I don't know well the names. And all these people, the government of Sri Lanka invited me to come here. I'm in a mission of observer to study the topic persons. And if the government accepts, in a short time, I'm sure that we can collaborate and cooperate with you in some of these points, maybe in other points. For example, I talked to you 20 minutes ago that now there are Portuguese television that you can see here with music, with dances, with language, with news, and so on. It's not expensive to see Portuguese television here. It's one thing for us, for two things. And they are our children. Because it's important today. As you know, I don't know if you know that Portuguese is the fifth language in the world. Only in Brazil there are 200 million that speak Portuguese. Now Portuguese is a member of the European Union. And now each day is more important than before. Because it's one of the main doors to all people who come to Europe, to work, to learn in schools and so on. We have lots of fields, some up there to cooperate. Now we go to talk. I have a big emotion to see the red and white of my flag, of my country. I know almost all the world. And this, we like our land. We like our land. I like my land. But we
thank you. I'm going to go to the hospital.